I live two blocks away from here, and it was kind of weird this morning because I would have normally been walking my dog. I walk my dog past there every day. This is a quiet neighborhood. You know how they always say nothing ever happens like that around here? Well, nothing like this ever happens around here. This morning I was recording my show in my studio, and while I'm recording, I actually made fun of sirens all around, like they're coming to get me. It's part of the show that you can hear on Thursday. And so I didn't know idea what was going on until I came up here, and suddenly all hell was breaking loose.
What did you see when you came down to this area?
Flame. A lot of flame, and then black smoke, heavy black smoke. At a couple of times, you could see it flared up again. At one point, I saw what looked like an officer with a gun drawn rushing toward the house, and we thought maybe it had come to an end, but obviously it still hasn't at this point.
Did you hear any gunshots?
I didn't hear the gunshot, actually, and I never heard anything like a shot once we got here. We were the first ones here, and it was just a lot of flame, a lot of black smoke, and nothing after the initial report of hearing what sounded like a shot.
So quiet neighborhood, but this morning, flames, black smoke, an officer charging towards the house with guns drawn. We've also heard reports from witnesses who say that they saw officers roaming around between the homes, with their guns drawn. Again, as this went from a fire and turned into a tactical situation just about almost 3 hours ago.
It looks like the initial danger is certainly gone. The tactical situation has been declared to be over with. You see firefighters now with a ladder against the house. They're looking into that second story, trying to determine if someone tragically was trapped up on that second floor and may have died in this fire. The initial call reported that two people were in the home. According to what the police chief knows, one of those people did get out of the home. He has not had a chance to speak to that person, at least at the time of the news conference, to speak with them directly. So he was getting this information from other emergency crews who were on the scene. And so firefighters right now trying to check that home out to see if someone was in fact trapped in the home. For the people who live in that neighborhood, they're still not being allowed in. We Energy's crews were there. Power had been cut off. It's not clear when they're going to restore that power. That is done when anytime there's a chance of a fire spreading or there's other possibilities of some sort of danger erupting from having the fire left on. So they cut off the power to the neighborhood. They evacuated people in surrounding homes, and they're keeping them away from that area until they're absolutely sure that it's safe for people to return. And we-